Yes, hello members, you are most welcome once again. As usual, Saddam Hussein, your mathematics teacher, is back. I'm always very happy for all of you who are viewing my videos, subscribing, doing whatever, commenting. You are really doing a very great job. I like that, and I believe the Almighty God will keep blessing you with that love as we continue working together. They said no man is an island. I can't stand without you, and you can't also stand without me. So we need to be together so that we push ourselves to the victor's crown. One time we shall be there. So as usual, I told you with me, I'm handling a lot of application. Where we are moving now is full of application. The knowledge learned, how does someone apply it in daily life? We don't only learn theoretically and leave it there. But we want to see how we can apply. Most of these topics in mathematics involve application, by the way. And secondly, the trend of setting examinations is looking at application. We are looking at how to develop citizens who can easily apply the knowledge learned from class in their daily lives. When you want those application questions, just subscribe. You'll always get them here, time and again, and things will be okay for you. So today I want to look at something about finite system. This is finite system. It's all about the groupings. That's why we are looking at specifically the days, the month. We all know that a week has 7 days, a year has 12 months. So we are looking at that kind of groupings. And when we are dealing with those finites, we have finites depending on the system you are dealing with, depending on what you are handling. Today, I want us to look at how best we can apply. If today it happens to be a Monday, what day of the week will it be after 100 days, after 200 days? Those are the questions what I enjoyed. Remember last time I taught it, and now I've brought another way of applying it in our daily lives. If practically someone may ask me, how do I apply this at home? Yes. For example, if you tell someone that you want to meet him after 50 days, instead of struggling there, almost even biting your fingers, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, you even want to pick the toes and count, you want to count everything, you are counting jerrycans at home, you are counting everything. That is not how we do it. A simple formula, after doing it today here, it becomes very simple. You don't even need to count and as if you want to bite your fingers. No. It's just about application of the formula, and you'll find yourself moving direct. When somebody tells you that what will be the day after 1 million days, he will tell him, it's okay. Give me only 3 minutes, you will see the answer there. That's what we are looking at. Applying the knowledge of how we can do it in our daily lives. Is that together? Now, if today is Monday, 10th of May, by the way, these kind of questions, I've never forgotten my teacher, may he so rest in peace. In primary 6, they brought for us such a question. Actually, it was saying if today, that's why I like Monday, by the way. If today is Monday, what day of the week will it be after 42 days? I've never forgotten that question in my life. It was when I was in primary 6 class. Now, being a child, remember the paper we did it on Wednesday, and this paper is saying if today is Monday, I just crossed the Monday, I wrote there Wednesday. Because it was really Wednesday, we did the paper on Wednesday. I want to tell you, the canes I received, I've never forgotten them, because it was my own stupidity which made me think about that. But after all, I was a child, I think I didn't understand it well. But that's why we, the mathematicians, say, if I don't understand the meaning of if, I wish I knew, that wouldn't happen like that. So if we use the word if, it doesn't mean that necessarily today is Monday. We are using if, those people who are good at English, you know, if one, if two, if three. So when we talk about the if, we are predicting that, actually we are just assuming that if today is Monday, what day of the week will it be? We are just assuming, yes, you might be doing the paper on Thursday, or you might be answering the question on Thursday, but you assume that day is a Monday, which will never be, of course, but we use the word, we use that if. So I also want that you, whenever you're watching this video of mine, even if you're watching it on a Sunday, don't contradict and say, again, he's saying Monday, yet today I'm very sure it's a Sunday. Don't be like me, because me, I received my share I don't know what may happen to you if you cross my Monday and put a Thursday. Okay, that was for that. Let us move on. If today is Monday, 10th of May, Monday, 10th of May, what day of the week will it be on 18th November of the same year? Remember the other time we looked at, if today is Monday, what day of the week will it be after 42 days? Will it be, that is future tense. But this time they've given us the month instead. They've told us that it's Monday, 10th of May. What day of the week will it be on 18th of November? So what we are supposed to do is that we are supposed to calculate the number of days in the month. In the month which have been stated from Monday, 10th of May to November 18th. Now, you'll find that if your first month happens to be May, you have June there, you have July there, you have August there, we have September there, we have October there, and we have now November final. So these are the months that have been given. May, June, July, August, September, October, November. Before you reach November, you cannot skip this month in the middle. They're supposed to be included. Remember, we are cutting number of days. Now, in the first month, since they are telling us word of the week will, so that is future tense, meaning that if today is 10th, meaning that the days, remember, May has 31 days in that month. There are 31 days in that month. So, we have already occupied the 10. How many days are left ahead? Remember, what day of the week will it be? So we are moving ahead. So the days left ahead in May are supposed to be included. That is 31 minus 10. Then, how many days are there in the month of June? June has 30 days. Remember, we used to sing, 30 days are September, April, June, and November. All the rest have 31 days except February, which has 29 or 28. February has 29 days in a leap year, which has 366 days. And it has 28 days in an ordinary year, which has 365 days. You should be very careful. And leap years come after 4 years. That is a simple knowledge for us to know. Now, June has 30, then July has 31, August has 31. These are the 2 months which follow each other with 31 days each. Then September has 30, October has 31. Now, what do we do for the last month? The last month, we only pick the date which has been given. Remember the first one, when they're talking about the future tense, what day of the week will it be? Will it be? The first month given, we pick its remainder. We pick the number of days that month, we subtract 10, which is the date. If it was 20th, we subtract 20. If it was 11th, we subtract 11. But now we are dealing with the first month of the month. According to what they've given us there, the first month is May. So we shall say 31, which are the number of days in May, minus 10, which is the day, which gives you 21. Then June has not been touched, so it is consolidated there. July is there, 31. August, 31. September, 30. October, 31. And this last month mentioned here, you pick the date. You don't subtract again. You say, since November has 30 days, you subtract 30 minus 18. No. Remember, the remaining 12 days have not attached. But we have so far entered 18 days into the month. Are we together? That's what I pray for you to just accept and understand with me, because things are going to be fine and everything will be okay. I'm still emphasizing that Monday, if today is Monday, 10th of May, what day of the week will the future? Since the question is talking about will, that means we shall get the number of days left in the month of May, which is 31 minus 21. I mean 31 minus 10 to give you 21. Then June, which is not attached, will also be there. For you to reach November, you must go through June, July, August, September, and October before you reach it, November. So those days are supposed to be. Don't just say May 21 plus 18 of November. You will have left this month in the middle. So you have to add the days there. When you add 21 plus 30, you get 51. Then this is 62. Then this is 61 plus 18. Now from here you come and add 51 plus 62 plus 61 plus 18. Don't forget that symbol. Now when you're adding 1 plus this is 3 plus this, which is 4. 4 plus 8 is 12. You write 2, you regroup 1. 1 plus this is 6. 6 plus 6 is 12 plus 6, 18. Are we together? 9 plus this, which is 19. Those are 100 92 days. Now the question becomes very simple. You cannot reframe it according to what you did last time. If today is Monday, what day of the week will it be after 192 days? Very simple, you can see. Looks complicated, but very simple. As long as you just master, you are done. Everything becomes fine. From this point in time, we now move and say, we have Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, and Saturday. The first day of the week, remember, is Sunday. That is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. According to whole numbers, 0 is the first whole number. So infinite 7, a week has 7 days. So that is finite 7. Infinite 7, instead of writing 7, you write 0. Remember, we deal with remainders under finite. Now, if today is Monday, you pick that Monday. What day of the week will, when we're talking about future tense, we add? That is, will it be after 192 days? We don't know, but it is infinite 7. That's what I'm talking about here. I want us to be very careful because this thing is very interesting, by the way. From today now, after learning, you can now tell your people at home, yes, please, what can we do here? Today is Monday, I'm coming back after 900 days. Let them calculate. Give them also time to do. By the way, this is one of the questions which can easily be done practically, and you will find if you want to prove it, yes, take your time and tally until you make 192 days and you prove whether this answer is right. So 1 plus 192 gives you 193. So this number is too big. You want to write it infinite 7. When you're writing infinite 7, you divide by 7. You want to write it infinite 7. So this is 193 divided by 7. By 7, you have 1. 19 by 7, you get 2 for 14. 2 for 14. Remainder 5. Now 53 divided by 7. You get 7 for 49, remainder 4, remainder 4. This is where our interest is. That's why I am not leaving it. I am with it. This is where our interest is. What does 4 stand for? 4 stands for Thursday. 4 stands for Thursday. Therefore, it will be a Thursday on the 18th November, same year. Thursday, 18th November, same year. If today is 10th, Monday 10th of May, I told you this date, you subtract the number of days in that month of May minus the date to give you 21. Then the month which is in the middle, don't forget to put their days there because they cannot be skipped. They are supposed to be included. So you add them, as you have seen what I've done, 21 plus 31 plus 31 plus 30 plus 31 plus 18. The second month mentioned here, you pick the date exactly, since we're talking about the future tense, what will. Next time when I bring the other question where we are looking at the other one, what was the past now? What day was it? That one now, we're also going to handle it. It will be a little bit different, but these other things, of course, will be the same. We shall see how this month and the other first one behave. That's why I'm telling you that things will be interesting and everything will be fine. Just feel free. We shall move on and all the things will be as required. I want to appreciate you all for attending and please be together with me because this is how we move and this is the practical things I'm talking about. That me, I'm too practical. I want us to move on very well and we see how we can approach these questions. In case of any statement, any question, you can write it in the comment section. Continue subscribing, continue viewing, continue commenting. I am with you. May the Almighty God bless you. I love you so much.